Belinda presents this unabridged recording of Animal Ark Collection 2. Written by Lucy Daniels and read by Charlie Sanderson. Doggie Drama. Chapter 1. Amelia Haywood beamed with pride as she gazed at the sign by the door of the stone cottage. Animal Ark, Veterinary Surgery.
My dream has come true.
Ever since she had moved to the village of Welford a few months ago, she had wanted to help out at Animal Ark. At first, Mr. and Mrs. Hope, the vets who owned the surgery, had thought that Amelia was too young. But she and her friend Sam had proved that they were up to the job. Now they were officially helping out at Animal Ark on weekends and some mornings before school.
Am I late?
Amelia turned to see Sam round the bend in the lane and ran up to her, his school backpack on his shoulder.
You don't need to rush, we're early, she called.
I couldn't get away, Sam said, gasping for breath. Mac kept trying to follow me.
Mac was Sam's cute Westie puppy.
Maybe he was upset that he couldn't come, Amelia laughed. But we've got too many other animals to look after this morning.
You certainly do. It was Mrs. Hope, her red hair bobbing as she climbed the steps behind them. She unlocked the door and let Amelia and Sam into the empty waiting room, while Mr. Hope parked their car.
What should we do first?
Asked Amelia eagerly. Mrs. Hope smiled. You can start by looking after the animals in the hotel. The hotel was what the Hopes called the overnight stay area. It was where Star had stayed with her mum and the other kittens after they were born. Amelia and Sam had fed the kittens and played with them. Now Star was Amelia's very own kitten. Julia Kaminsky, the receptionist, arrived next, wheeling her wheelchair up the ramp behind Mr. Hope. Hello, you two. She smiled at Amelia and Sam as she turned on the computer at the reception desk. I'll get ready for today's appointments, said Mrs. Hope. Would you check the emails, Julia? She asked the receptionist. Let me know if there's anything urgent. Of course, Julia replied. Mrs. Hope went into her office, while Amelia and Sam followed Mr. Hope down the corridor, past the examination rooms to the hotel. As they entered the overnight room, a strange, high-pitched voice called out.
What a naughty boy! What a naughty boy!
Sam jumped, startled.
Who said that?
Amelia laughed when she realised that the voice came from a bright green parrot in a large bird cage. She peered inside for a closer look and saw a dressing around one of the parrot's wings.
Meet Gabby, said Mr. Hope. She flew into a window and broke her wing.
He pointed to a grey rabbit sleeping on a pile of straw, a bandage across her middle.
Hoppy had surgery to remove a tumour in his stomach, and Clementine has an infected foot,
he finished, pointing to a tortoise in a tank.
Poor things, said Sam.
They're all on the road to recovery, said Mr. Hope. It will just take time.
While Mr. Hope checked their wounds, Amelia and Sam cleaned the pens.
Gross,
said Sam, wiping gooey bird droppings out of Gabby's cage.
Gross,
the parrot repeated. Amelia laughed. She had to agree. But it's worth it to be around these animals. She cleaned out Hoppy's rabbit droppings, then lined the hutch with fresh paper and straw.
Great job, said Mr. Hope when they had finished. Remember to wash your hands.
Amelia grinned at Sam as they washed their hands at the sink. Mr. Hope led them back down the corridor to the reception area. There, a black and white sheepdog sat at the feet of a large farmer with a bushy grey beard. The dog's chin rested on the man's Wellington boot.
Good morning, Mr. Nichols, said Mr. Hope. What's the matter with Lucy? She's off her food, the farmer replied. I think she might have a tummy ache.
Mr. Hope knelt down and gently opened the dog's mouth.
Plucking a small torch from his shirt pocket, he peered inside. The dog whined.
Poor creature, whispered Amelia. Her belly must really hurt.
It's not her tummy, it's her tooth, said Mr. Hope. It will need to be taken out, I'm afraid. We'll do it this morning, and you can collect Lucy this afternoon.
Mr. Nichols stroked the dog's head. Mr. Hope led the way to the treatment room, calling for Lucy to follow, but she stayed loyally by the farmer's side.
Go with Mr. Hope, Lucy, he said. I'll see you this afternoon.
The clever sheepdog looked back at her owner, then trotted into the treatment room.
Mr. Hope will take good care of her, Amelia assured the farmer.
I know, said Mr. Nichols. I hope we find a vet as nice as him in our new town.
You're moving, said Sam.
Mr. Nichols nodded.
I've retired and sold all of my animals, apart from Lucy and my two llamas.
Llamas in Welford?
Amelia exclaimed. She was always discovering new things in the countryside.
Yes, but I need to find them a new home, Mr. Nichols said.
You can put a sign up here.
Amelia pointed to the notice board that covered a wall in the reception area. There were lots of posters giving advice to pet owners, but also a section about missing animals and animals needing new homes.
Sam and I will help too. We found homes for 4 kittens, said Sam proudly.
Llamas are a bit bigger than kittens. Do you really think you could find someone to adopt them?
He asked doubtfully. Amelia grinned at Sam, and he grinned back.
We'll give it a shot, said Amelia.
Chapter 2. As Mr. Nichols left the surgery, he held the door for a young woman with short hair tucked behind her ears. She was carrying an animal wrapped in a blanket. A furry brown tail peeked through the folds.
Hi, Miss Sachs, said Sam.
Amelia realised it was their drama club teacher from school. Tucked in the blanket, a cute little brown Yorkshire terrier gazed back at them with big eyes. A cast covered one of his front legs.
Oh no, said Amelia. What happened?
He was trying to swim, said Miss Sachs.
She sighed and rubbed the puppy's ears.
Oscar can't resist playing in the water. He jumped into a river, but the water was too shallow. His leg broke when he hit the bottom. Luckily, he's having his cast taken off today.
Mrs. Hope called Miss Sachs and Oscar into the treatment room. You two can come and help, she said to Amelia and Sam. They shared an excited smile and followed Miss Sachs and the patient. In the treatment room, Mrs. Hope lifted Oscar onto the examining table. Sam stroked him gently to keep him calm, while Amelia held his leg still for Mrs. Hope. Carefully, she cut the cast off with a large pair of scissors. Oscar yawned and licked his lips nervously, but he didn't flinch.
What a good dog, thought Amelia.
Mrs. Hope unwrapped the bandage and padding that was underneath the cast, then felt along Oscar's leg. Amelia watched intently.
It feels like the break has healed, said Mrs. Hope.
What do you think, little guy? Do you want to try walking on it? Gently, she put Oscar on the floor. Amelia held her breath. Oscar lifted his bad leg off the floor and hobbled along on his 3 good legs. He stopped and his tail drooped.
Go on, Oscar,
Miss Sachs encouraged him. But the dog just lay down at her feet. He sniffed at the newly exposed leg and licked the fur.
Poor Oscar, said Amelia. He's not feeling very playful.
I guess he's not ready to put any weight on it yet, said Mrs. Hope. It will take some time for him to get back to normal. In the meantime, he'll need some light exercise, along with lots of extra love and attention.
Oh dear, Miss Sachs frowned. The school play is coming up, and I haven't got much time right now.
Amelia exchanged a glance with Sam. Last week, they'd auditioned for parts in the school play, but with all the excitement of becoming a helper at Animal Ark, Amelia had forgotten about it.
My usual dog walker takes Oscar out with a group of dogs, so he can't give Oscar any extra attention, Miss Sachs continued. What am I going to do?
Amelia leaned over and stroked Oscar's smooth, silky fur.
I wish there was something I could do to help, she murmured, as the dog nuzzled his soft, warm nose into her hand.
Me too, added Sam.
Miss Sachs wrapped the dog up in the blanket again and carried him to the door.
I'll see you two at drama club, she called to Amelia and Sam.
After Miss Sachs and Oscar had left, Mrs. Hope said,
So, you two are budding actors as well as vets.
We're doing The Wizard of Oz, Sam told her. I want to be the Tin Man.
I auditioned to be Dorothy, said Amelia.
And is Matt going to be Dorothy's dog, Toto? Asked Mrs. Hope.
I hope so, said Sam. He'd be great on stage. He's really well behaved now, most of the time anyway.
Talking about the play reminded Amelia that they still had a whole day of school ahead of them. She looked at her watch.
Sam, we'd better go or we'll be late.
Well, thanks for all your help, said Mrs. Hope. See you again tomorrow morning.
Obviously, Miss Sachs will pick me to be Dorothy, Tiffany declared after school. I'm going to be a famous actress when I grow up.
Sam rolled his eyes and Amelia stifled a giggle. The drama club was in the classroom waiting for Miss Sachs to come and announce the cast for The Wizard of Oz.
And Sparkle will make the perfect Toto, Tiffany continued. He's so clever. He can roll over, sit up and beg, and even fetch my headphones.
Sparkle was Tiffany's Bichon Frise, a fluffy white puppy who she usually carried around in a special backpack. Just then, Miss Sachs arrived, followed by Oscar on his lead. The tiny terrier was still hobbling on three legs. Amelia knelt down next to him.
Hello, Oscar. Remember me?
His tail wagged as he licked her hand.
If I could only help you get better, thought Amelia.
Gather round, everyone, said Miss Sachs.
She held up a clipboard. I've got the cast list here. Immediately, everyone was quiet. Amelia's heart beat faster.
I'm afraid you can't all have the part you want, Miss Sachs continued. Otherwise, we'd have seven Dorothys. But you're all important to the success of the play, no matter which role you have.
She looked at her list.
The role of the Cowardly Lion goes to Caleb. Carell, I've chosen you to be the Tin Man.
Amelia glanced over at Sam. He looked disappointed.
Sam, I think you'll make an excellent scarecrow, said Miss Sachs.
Cool!
Sam's face immediately lit up, his brown eyes sparkling.
Izzy, you've got the part of Glinda the Good Witch, Miss Sachs went on.
Amelia saw her friend clap her hands with glee. And Tiffany, said Miss Sachs, with your dramatic talent, I think you'll be perfect for...
Dorothy! Tiffany shouted. I'm Dorothy!
Actually, said Miss Sachs, you're going to be the Wicked Witch of the West.
But who's playing Dorothy?
Wailed Tiffany. Miss Sachs looked at her clipboard.
Well, I had a tough choice, especially as so many of you tried out to be Dorothy, but I've decided to cast Amelia because she did such a great audition.
Me?
Amelia wasn't sure she'd heard correctly.
Well done, Amelia, said Sam.
Amelia blushed, especially when her friends gathered round to congratulate her. But she spotted Tiffany glaring at her from the other side of the room.
Miss Sachs, who's going to be Toto?
Asked Sam. Miss Sachs smiled. Well, I've heard your dog Mac is very well trained, so it makes sense for him to take the role. Toto is supposed to be a terrier, after all. Everyone erupted into cheers, all except for Tiffany, who was dabbing her eyes with a tissue. Even though Tiffany wasn't very nice, Amelia was sorry to see her upset. She took a deep breath and walked over to her.
The Wicked Witch is actually a really good part, Tiffany.
No, it's not,
Tiffany scowled at her.
You can have loads of fun cackling and casting spells,
Amelia went on.
The Wicked Witch is the real star of the play.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.